A healthy forest will always be changing. We think of forests as static, but they're not static at all. They're continually changing. Forest succession is literally changes in the forest, and it typically happens after an extreme disturbance or a stress event where an entire vegetation or a forest dies, whether it's a wildfire or a wind disturbance or an ice storm. This whole restart of the vegetation happens from the grass stage to the mature forest stages. There are grasses first, which are followed by herb layer, by shrubs, and then by younger trees, and then finally by mature trees. So there is a gradual transition. And it's not only the plants that are undergoing succession, it's actually also the animal communities that are undergoing succession as well. The forest management practices that are used in any given forest stand are really dependent upon the landowner's or forest manager's objectives. If the objective is to have some sort of a natural forest, then we allow the disturbance events to happen and we allow for natural succession to happen. However, if the objectives are to manage the forest for economic purposes, here in Georgia we have a lot of pine plantations, for example, then there are tons and tons of management practices that can be done, starting from thinning to herbicide treatment to prescribed burning in many areas, fertilization and so forth.
When it comes to healthy forests, healthy really means a community of fully functional trees and other plants, but also animals and also the physical environment. So there are two main points here. The first is that it's a community. It's not a single tree. You can have sick trees, you can have dying trees in a perfectly healthy forest because it's the community that counts. And the other important term here is functional, which means that the health of a forest is strictly linked to whatever is the function of that forest. It could be a productive forest, it could be recreational. They will look different, but they both can be healthy. Indicators of a healthy forest will be mainly vigorous canopies and understory, and the number of dying or dead trees have to be adequate for the function of the forest. If it's a productive forest, you want the minimum. If it's a recreational forest or biodiversity conservation, you can have more. You want to have a forest that is able to recover after any type of disturbance. You want to have as little as possible of erosion. You want to have good quality of water. You want to have a good number of aquatic species and an adequate number of wildlife species, which is not too little, but also not too much. If you have too many wildlife animals, that also it's a sign of unhealthy balance in the forest. Insect and diseases, you want to have the right amount.
A native species is native to a geographical region and is adapted to the local conditions, and the environment itself is adapted to that particular species. In terms of an invasive species, it has expanded its geographical range and it can cause high impacts. Scientists make an important distinction in terms of invasive species. We have native invasives and we have non-native invasives. Native invasives are already present in the US, for example, and perhaps have been moved from Arizona to California, but the non-native invasives have actually come out of the country, and they tend to be a lot more damaging. The biggest environmental factors that influences the spread of invasive species are actually humans, because we are so much more connected globally, and there's so many new trade routes that are being that are emerging, that the invasive species has become bigger of a problem. And so a lot of regional economies are dependent upon these pine plantations, for example. And if there is an invasive species that come in on pine plantations, it can be devastating to the economy.
We really want to protect Georgia forests from invasive species because Georgia territory, it's mainly covered by forest. Almost 65% of our territory is covered by forest. And of this, more than a half is covered by plantations, so southern pine plantations. So we have to do our best to avoid any invasive species to come in. Whenever you see something that you think it's not native, look better into it and perhaps report it. A healthy forest is important because forests provide us a numerous number of different functions. And not only from the economical point of view, of course, the production of wood, but a healthy forest provides clean water, clean air to the environment. It provides biodiversity, provides habitats for insects, for animals. So all of these factors are very important. And if you don't have a healthy forest, you're not going to have those functions fulfilled.